Now, let me read another verse, 39 and verses 6 and 7. I'll read two here. And I will send a fire on Magog and among those who dwell securely in the coastlands, and they shall know that I'm the Lord. So will I make my holy name known in the midst of my people, Israel. And I will not let them pollute my holy name anymore, and the nation shall know that I'm the Lord, the Holy One of Israel. Now, the question is, where is God today? Why doesn't he do something? Why doesn't he move today? A few years ago, a group of Christians appeared in Moscow at the American embassy, and they appealed, actually weeping, and this was shown on TV, asking that they be permitted to leave Russia. And they were being persecuted. And our country did nothing. I haven't quite understood why we interfered down in Vietnam and why in Russia, Czechoslovakia, things are just as bad and we fold our arms. I don't know why when you move from east to west, things change like that. But they do, my friend. May I say to you that the Russian soldiers came and took those people away. I have waited again and again to hear the press say what happened to them, but they're not about to say what happened to them. May I say to you that the Soviet authorities were never dealt with, and that nation has been guilty of more anti-Semitism than any other nation over a period of years. And injustice is in the world. And the question today is, why does not God move? And there's no respect for God throughout the world today. They think he's just a jolly old man that shuts his eyes to the injustice in the world. My friend, I want to say this to you. Why doesn't God move? He is going to move. He'll vindicate his glory. He'll not do it in a vindictive and revengeful and petulant manner, but he's going to do that. And when he does, there will be a respect and reverence for God in this world, and that's the only thing that'll make little man bow before him. There's no respect of God today. Let me turn to two verses of scripture here. The first one is in Romans 2:3. And here he says, and thinkest thou this, O man, that judgest them which do such things, and thou doest the same, that thou shalt escape the judgment of God? Well, you're not going to escape. You're not getting by with it. And man today thinks he is, but he's not. And then again in Hebrews 2:3, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that heard it? I have a sermon on that verse, and the title of it is this, A Question That God Cannot Answer. How shall you escape if you neglect so great a salvation? Well, you can't escape. There's no answer to it at all. Now, let me use an old-fashioned square expression that just gags the liberal preachers, and unfortunately, it has the same effect on some so-called evangelicals who are attempting to make a name for themselves and sort of win over the world. They want to make the world a better place for people to go to hell in. And even some fundamentalists today are so busy trying to straighten out other fundamentalists that they have no time to deal with this subject, and here it is. My friend, hell is an awful reality, and you can interpret it as you will. It's a place where a holy God places those who are in rebellion against him, and those who sin with impunity, and those who blaspheme his holy name at will, those who live like animals in the name of freedom, but they are indulging in gross immorality. My friends, God's holy name is going to be vindicated. And how will it be vindicated? In love? Why, he's demonstrating his love today in giving his son. Those of us who name his name need to learn a lesson. We need to learn that you can't trifle with him. You can't get familiar with him. You can't live as you please and then buddy-buddy up to him. Our God is holy. And we need also to learn we can't presume upon him. We can't sin and get by with it. If you can, then God is no better than you are. My friend, I'm a creature, and I'm a sinner. And I am what I am now by the grace of God. And man is but a creature. God's will prevail. Our proper position is to bow before him. And my only liberty today is in the will of God. He remembers we are dust. But I can say with Paul, I obtain mercy. My friend, if you defy him, he'll trample you under his feet. But he'll love you, and he loves you. And the day is coming when they will not offend in my holy mountain, says the Lord. He's running everything, friends.